Hello friends, welcome back to another episode of Engineering Today, and hope you're all having a great time. Today, we're going to take you through some exciting news from Starship and SpaceX as they're making progress on the orbital launch mount and the construction of a new Megabay at the Sanchez site next to their production site. The existing Megabay is undergoing changes with scaffolding removal and new glass panels. Its future use is still unknown, as Ship 25 and Booster 9 have already been confirmed for the next integrated test flight. Cryo testing has been completed on both vehicles, and they're nearing readiness for static fires. The focus on the orbital launch mount repairs may have delayed the static fire tests. Foundation work is underway for the water deluge system and other infrastructure requirements. Additional steel reinforcement is being installed to repair concrete and foundation damage. A new steel plate will protect the ground from raptors. Elon Musk confirmed an upgrade in Starship's thrust with 33 Raptors, providing a total of 6,000 tons of thrust, a 20% improvement over previous versions. SpaceX is leaving no stone unturned to push the boundaries of innovation. This drive often entails rigorous testing, making adjustments, or even completely replacing existing structures to enhance their operations. A recent example of this adaptability is the removal of the low bay structure, originally constructed to shield against the wind during welding operations. However, it was determined to be ineffective, prompting the relocation of operations to the mid-bay, which offers superior protection. As time progressed, the low bay was repurposed to serve as storage and workspace for nose cones. But with the introduction of taller structures, the low bay became redundant, as these new structures now provide ample space for nose cone activities. Acknowledging the changing needs of requirements, SpaceX has planned to replace the low bay with an advanced facility known as the Star Factory. SpaceX has already conducted cryo tests and ventilation preparations on Ship 25, indicating progress toward static fire testing. Welding equipment is being used to complete welds around the base of the launch pad table. The booster quick disconnect cover has been removed for maintenance purposes. Elon Musk has mentioned that repairs on the orbital launch mount are going quite well, and they're expected to be completed in about a month, followed by a month of static fire tests. He recently provided the update on Starship Flight Test 2, indicating a potential launch attempt in August. SpaceX shared on Twitter on May 26th their progress towards reaching Mars, specifically highlighting the first flight test of a fully integrated Starship and Super Heavy rocket. They also provided behind-the-scenes footage and footage from the April flight. NASA's administrator, Bill Nelson, subsequently provided more precise estimates to Congress at the end of June, relaying that SpaceX had informed him that the next attempt would take at least 2 months. According to the earliest date shared by SpaceX with Administrator Nelson, the Starship Flight Test 2 would have taken place in late June. However, if all goes smoothly and just according to plan, the launch could now transpire in late July or in August. It's important to acknowledge that the drilling process is ongoing and that there remains a substantial amount of rebar work to be completed before the concrete can be laid. The thickness of the rebar plays a vital role in providing stability, particularly in terms of the strength of the crossbeams. Furthermore, there is a possibility that concrete pylons will be employed to interconnect the legs of the launch pad table, bolstering stability and preventing any potential sinking into the moist soil. Well, having said that, we should address another remarkable achievement of SpaceX. SpaceX is on the verge of a groundbreaking mission by launching the inaugural commercial space station of the world called Vast Haven 1. This will be followed swiftly by two manned spaceflight missions to the aforementioned space station. The launch is scheduled to take place no earlier than August 2025, employing a Falcon 9 rocket to carry the station to a low Earth orbit. Haven 1 will function independently as a fully operational space station and will eventually be integrated as a module into a larger space station known as VAST, which is currently under development. Once Haven 1 is launched, the Falcon 9 will be employed to undertake VAST's inaugural manned spaceflight mission to the commercial space station, Vast 1. The Dragon spacecraft, carrying a crew of 4 individuals, will rendezvous with Haven 1 and remain docked for a period of up to 30 days while orbiting the Earth. Additionally, Vast has secured the option for another manned spaceflight mission to the station, this time utilizing a Dragon spacecraft. The selection process for the Vast 1 crew is currently underway, and the chosen crew members will be announced at a later date. Upon finalization, SpaceX will be responsible for providing crew training on both the Falcon 9 rocket and the Dragon spacecraft. This will encompass emergency preparedness, exercises on spacesuit and spacecraft entry and exit, as well as comprehensive simulations of partial and full missions, including docking and undocking procedures for the return journey to Earth. VAST's ultimate objective is to construct a sprawling, multi-module, spinning, artificial gravity space station measuring 100 meters in length. This newfound collaboration between VAST and SpaceX will further enhance accessibility to space and create new opportunities for exploration. It signifies humanity's journey towards establishing a presence on multiple planets. And that's not all. While the quest for the truth beyond the cosmos is still on, SpaceX has already completed a remarkable task with the collaboration of Axiom Space. For the first time, 2 individuals from Saudi Arabia resided and worked on the International Space Station. Ali Al-Karni and Rayana Barnawi embarked on their journey to the orbiting laboratory on the AX-2 mission, a privately operated 4-person mission by the Houston-based company Axiom Space. These 2 individuals are only the 2nd and 3rd Saudis to ever venture into space, with Barnawi making history as the first woman from Saudi Arabia to reach the final frontier. According to their fellow crew members on the AX-2 mission, former NASA astronaut Peggy Whitson, who holds a record-breaking title, and paying customer John Schaffner, Al-Karni and Barnawi spent approximately 8 days aboard the ISS before returning to Earth in the SpaceX Crew Dragon capsule, aptly named Freedom. The AX-2 mission holds significant importance for commercial space travel as it marks the 2nd private astronaut mission to the ISS following Axiom's AX-1 mission in April 2022. Additionally, this mission is of great significance to Saudi Arabia as it aims to capitalize on the experience and expand its presence beyond Earth. On May 30th, Tuesday, the Saudi astronauts Rayana Barnawi and Ali Al-Karni departed from the International Space Station, marking the completion of their historic mission. The departure of the astronauts was live-streamed on the websites and social media channels of NASA, SpaceX, and Axiom Space. Axiom Space confirmed that all conditions, including the weather, are favorable for undocking. And that's all for now. If you enjoyed today's video, hit the like button to motivate us. Are you also counting on the SpaceX flight test too, like us? If so, what do you think about their recent preparation? Let us know your thoughts and opinions about Starship and SpaceX in the comment section below. Make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit that notification bell so you don't miss a thing. Thanks for joining us on this journey.